Hello, people of YouTube. I hope you're well. Welcome to my living room and to this special episode of my creative podcast. I'm Selma, and you can find me on the internet, mostly on Instagram and Ravelry, as Selma's Knits. Welcome if you're a new viewer, welcome back if you're a returning viewer. It's always a pleasure to have you with me for a new episode. Today, I will be presenting you my Make 9 for 2019. I think I've started seeing these Make 9 post on Instagram like 1 or 2 years ago, maybe. Basically, you create a collage of the 9 projects which you really want to make in the next year. You can do that with knitting, sewing, basically any kind of project you want. I'm only doing that with knitting because, well, I'm a bit more spontaneous with my sewing. I like to plan more knitting stuff. For this year, I really want to focus, at least during the first part of the year, on using stash yarn and library patterns, so stuff which I already have. So I can basically reduce my stash a bit and stop buying patterns which I end up never making because I have too many. Yeah, I'm going to give some love to what I already have. Most of the patterns I will show you, I already have the yarn for, and I do intend to not buy anything before EYF. I will go there with a list of stuff I need, of projects I want to make, because I found out, well, I recognize, and I'm probably not the same in that situation, that if I go with a plan, I am way less likely to be distracted and tempted by stuff which I will really, really like, but which I will end up never using because I don't have a pattern that goes with it. And it's a shame, really. I want to give some love to what I buy. I will show you the 9 projects which I'm planning on making. Hopefully I will have time to do more, particularly since I set myself a challenge of 25 finished objects by the end of this year on Ravelry. So we will see that, but 25 sounded like a good number. I went over my goal of 20 this year, well, last year, so 25 is fine. Anyway, grab your whip, grab your drink, and let's go. Let's start with the first project on my Make 9 list. It's the Tender Hat by Melodie Hoffman. She created it as a partnership with The Supportive Skein, which is a sort of knitting... It's not really a challenge, but let's say it's a knitting project, which is attached to a charity supporting a rare disease. I will put a link in the notes so that you can get more info about it if you want. But... basically, during the whole month of November, I think the proceeds of the pattern were going to this charity. I will make it with these two skeins. I don't know what the color would look like in the video, but it's a deep burgundy. The colorway is Madame Rêve. It's by Simone Yarn. 100% merino superwash and DK weight, and a kid mohair in silk in a lace weight, like most of these yarns. Anyway, I went for these because they match my Zaza sweater, and it's a color which I really want to add more of in my wardrobe. That really deep burgundy, I really, really like it. So I thought, why not? And can one really have too many hats? I don't think so. So that's my first project. Sometimes I need a bit more time to warm up to patterns, but this one I really liked from day one. I really like the chevron pattern all around the head. So I'm looking forward to making it. The second project on my Make 9 list is also a hat. But again, can one really have too many hats? I don't think so. It's the Hofsus hat by Stephen West. It's part of the patterns which he published when in his more, let's call it, sober years. I think I mentioned it in a previous episode of the podcast, but Stephen West, really, I find that he has a huge talent. There is no discussion there. But I feel more attracted to his previous works, mostly, I guess, because the colors there are more neutral and more muted, and
they fit my aesthetic better. I recognize that it's a bit dumb because you can adapt any pattern to any kind of color, obviously. But I like stuff which is a bit more streamlined mostly than what he offered recently, which is perfectly okay, to each their own. And yeah, so going back to the pattern, I've had it for 2 years in my queue on Ravelry, and I've had the yarn for over 2 years as well, because I bought it basically a week after I put the pattern in my queue. I chose these three colors. So this one is Lille Sock by Lille Weasel, which is it's a Parisian shop, and they also dyed their own yarn. The colorway is called Zinc. And these two are Malabrigo Sock. This one is Eggplant. This one, the dark one. And the light one is Pearl. Pearl is a gray with a slightly lavender undertone, so it will work. It works really well with them, with Eggplant. The pattern has a very, very interesting succession of patterns on it, of motifs, let's say. So I think it will look really nice in these muted colors. I think they will really showcase the various patterns on the hat. And as I said, it's been in my queue for 2 years, so it's high time I finally make it. The third pattern I want to make, I will not show you the yarn yet because I will make it using leftovers from other projects, but it's the Maya's Mameluka by Maya Carlson, and it's basically shorts. It's a bit more fun than sweaters or hats or any kind of stuff like that. I don't have a pair of woolly shorts. And since I really like wearing skirts and dresses, even in winter, and I've gone back to riding a bike to go to the office, I think it would be really nice to prevent my bum getting cold. And that's a good thing. So I'm looking forward to starting it. As I said, I will use leftovers, so it will probably not be just one color. But who cares, because it's supposed to be worn under clothes anyway. And I thought I could maybe bring it to my... I'm going on a training in the next 3 weeks. But then I thought, I will probably not make many friends there if I start with bringing my knitted underpants to my lunch break, you know. So I will take something a bit more neutral as a project, let's say. That's it for the shorts. The next project is also a small one, and then we're done with small projects and we can go on to more serious stuff. It's a pair of socks. It's the Suzette socks by Julie Parti, Lily Comme Tout. I don't think the pattern exists in English, but it's in French. And Julie gifted it to me when I explained that I have a kind of block against socks, that I have never been able to finish one pair. But as I said in a previous episode, again, I probably didn't choose the right yarn and the right pattern for a first pair. This is something I really, really want to do in 2019. I want to learn to knit socks. Because, well, I knit mittens and mitts, and how different can that be? I think it's the heel that stresses me out, but it shouldn't. So the pattern is very detailed and very well explained, so I think I should be able to make them. I will use this kit by Squirrels Yarns. It's Plume de Héron, the light gray, and Fleur Séchée, which is a pale pink rose. And I think these light colors will be good to maybe spot any mistakes I make when I make them, rather than a very dark color. And I like neutrals anyway. Socks are my 2019 challenge. I want to learn to make socks. I think I will need moral support a lot. But also, there is another pair of socks which I really want to make, which I will show you once I actually finish these and get on to making it, because it's a special pair that was, well, the pattern was gifted to me by a special friend, and I really want to make them this year. But first, practice. So the next project is slightly bigger. It's a cardigan. Well, it's a shrug. It's the Iris Shrug by Melody Hoffman. Again, it's the only designer I have two patterns of in my Make 9 list. I will make it using this super soft 100% wool by Magazine Duet. I won it during the knit along for the Making Stories. I don't really remember. I think it was Breeze. When I knit my Norte cardigan, the light gray one which I made in 90 days. Anyway, I finished it and I entered it in the cowl and I won eight balls of this super soft. It's pretty thin. I think it's light fingering. Yeah, because it's 50 grams, 280 meters. So yes, it is light fingering yarn. And I think it will look really nice in the shrug because it's a very airy pattern, basically. It's it has lace all over. I think this shrug will look really nice either inside in a more cozy environment or outside as a more dressed up piece. So I'm looking forward to making it. And that's also why I chose the gray, because it's it goes with everything. It's graphite, actually. They call it graphite, so it's very, very dark gray. The next project is also a cardigan, but this one will be like a super basic piece, which I want to make because I recognize lately that I don't have any cardigans which I can wear anymore. I have just the light gray one, the Norto, which I made last year. But I don't have any basic cardigan anymore. All the ones I had were coming from regular stores, and they, let's say they reached the end of their lives. They've been mended several times already, so they need to go. They need to go, and I want to make something a bit more decent to wear now. So it will be a black cardigan. I'm going to use the Sirva pattern by Marie-Amélie Designs, and this yarn, which is the only black colorway from By Simone on her 100% Merino Superwash base. And this is the 150 gram skein. So it's 600 meters. I have two of these and I bought them in May with the Sirva in mind. So I really want to make this pattern. It's really nice with a very pretty braid on the front, well, along the neckline. And since I really need a basic black cardigan, it will be one of the first ones of the year. One of the first projects. The next project is actually a very interesting one, and it's going to be my first colorwork sweater, and it's going to be the Winterfjell by Skeindeer Knits. I bought the yarn for it last year at EYF, and I got special help from the lovely Katie Green. And by the way, if you don't know her podcast, The Green Bean, I really, really recommend it. It's one of my favorites. So she helped me choose the yarn from Blacker, and it's gray and white Shetland and navy blue British wool. It's not specified, but anyway. All in the 4-ply bases, and so the body will be gray and the colorwork part will be white and blue. I loved this pattern from day one, so I bought it and then I decided to make it, but I never got around to doing it, so it will be the year I make the Winterfjell. It's just that it's a waste, you know. You buy the pattern, you buy the yarn, and you may never make the stuff. And two or 3 years later, when you finally have time, or when you finally decide to start it, you just don't like it that much anymore. So I should really make it while I like it. Although I think it's not a pattern I will get bored with. I think it will be my next pattern after the Sirva, after the cardigan. For the next two projects, I don't have yarn yet. So they will be on my EYF list. Well, EYF, and there are at least two more festivals before EYF. So we will see how it goes. But I will make a list. So the two patterns are the Vertical Stripes Sweater by Petite Knit. I want to make it in light gray because I have another light gray sweater, but it's V-neck. And I want something which is a bit warmer. So I will probably go for something which is very close to the original one from the pattern. I like the texture created by the like thick ribs along the body. I'm not a fan of stripes, generally speaking, but these vertical ones look really, really nice and very interesting. So I think I will make it in the second part of the year, like the next one, because I don't have the yarn yet. and I want to focus on the ones which I have already. But yeah, it's going to be an interesting knit, I think. The last pattern on my Make 9 list is another colorway sweater, and again, it was love at first sight with it. It's the Serious Sweater by Camilla Vaud. I think I will make it again in gray. Gray, black, and that kind of colors. Basically the same as the one she has on her Instagram. Same style. Because I really need more basic things. I only started knitting sweaters last year, so I don't have that many knitted sweaters. I have sweatshirts, which were store-bought, but I really want to make more knitted sweaters. And yeah, color work is kind of my thing now. So I'm going to go on and add more to my collection. Rather than basic, let's say neutral. And then, once I have all the neutrals and the basics covered, I will expand to more original stuff, let's say. But there you go, you have my Make 9 knitting list. And I hope you enjoyed seeing what my plans are. It was nice to review them with you. I'm curious to know if you have set yourself a challenge for 2019 as well. So if you have, let me know in the comments. And if you haven't, let me know as well. Because, I don't know, I guess it's fun for me to set challenges, but it's probably not for everyone. So I'd like to know what your thoughts are about it.
I want to wish you a very, very happy new year. May it bring you joy and happiness in all aspects of your life. I just hope that 2019 is a good year for you.
I will be on a training for the next 3 weeks, so I think I will have pretty busy days and short weekends, so most likely not that much time to knit. But yeah, I will come back at the end of January and show you what I've been up to. Until then, enjoy your knitting, your sewing, your everything, and take good care. See you soon. Bye.